you know, you're not going to create anything for you in retirement, you're not going to create anything if anything happens to you. And also what your position will actually be if the pension, if the building doesn't get leased. So there's still fees to pay as part of the pension fund, so somebody has to pay them. And if there's no rental income coming in, then you know, you'll have to stump up. The other thing is, if you are a business and you're putting your business property into the pension, you have to think about how you're going to borrow or what security you're going to put up later on for borrowings. Because once the building's in the pension scheme, then you don't have that building anymore. It doesn't belong to you as a company. So you have to kind of consider that as well. Make sure that you speak to a solicitor and a financial advisor who have practical experience of this. We have had numerous people coming to us where they spoke to a financial advisor who in theory knows what they're doing, but actually the practical implications of that, they have no idea how to actually manage the project through with the provider, the solicitor, even the accountant, the architects. So all these people have to partner with each other to make sure it's a success. And there are rules, and then there are rules. So there are inland revenue rules that allow you to do certain things, and then there are specific provider rules which will allow you to do things, and the two can be completely different. So you need to be aware of that. Timescales, and this is basically what David said. Please, you know, advise all your clients to give yourself plenty of time to get these things through. Pension transfers can take up to 3 months to come through, depending on you know, what scheme it's coming from. Even sort of elections for VAT, that has to happen before the property is actually transferred into the pension. And given the inland revenue, it can take quite a long time to get that election. So you don't want to be promising, you know, to have projects completed and then have to go back to what can do it because of the waiting for that election. So this is really important. And also, even from the simple point of view that your pension provider deals with hundreds of cases, it could be that they've got a lack of staff. So, you know, they could have backlogs and it means that your projects are held up. So, you know, you need to speak to the provider beforehand as well. Clients should make sure that they not only provide the funding and pension for the actual project work, but they should leave a bit of slush fund to cover things like stamp duty, land tax, VAT, legal costs and other fees which all need to be paid. So again, it's really important that you sit down with all the advisors and discuss that before you proceed. And then you need to consider the overall cost of the exercise in relation to saving and tax. We have quite a lot of business people that come to us say that they want to buy property through a pension. But when you actually do the sums of what it costs to do it and to pay everybody, actually it doesn't make sense for smaller projects. You're really looking at sort of above 150,000. You need to make it worthwhile for the cost involved as well. So it's not just a tax thing purely. It really is overall cost. So we need to have a good look at them. But the good news is that actually, if you actually sit down at the start of the project and work with your advisors, we've had these type of schemes go through in a matter of a couple of months. We've actually done one, our target was 3 weeks. So you just need to make sure that you deal with the professionals. You deal with the people who have practical experience of this, who can take a case and know exactly what they're doing. You know, solicitors that actually deal with property purchase and conventions, architects who know that the project's actually going to work, the providers know what's going to happen, can tell the client what they need to do before they embark on the project. So it really can move very quickly as long as you have all your ducks in line. Most importantly for us is that somewhere down the line, and all the passion and love that building and want to do something with it, somebody needs to take a step back and find out how that fits in the overall holistic plan of the individual, you know, how it fits into the their lifetime planning? You know, are they doing it just because it's a passion, or does it actually fit in with, you know, what they want to create for their life plan as well? Because there's nothing so disappointing, and believe me, I have clients that have done this, where they're left with a project that, although it was beautiful, it actually adds nothing at all to what they wanted to do throughout their life. You know, when you look at later life, they suddenly decide they want to travel, but because they've put so much into this particular project to create this beautiful goal, they really don't have enough liquidity to actually do something else later on. So it really does take a little bit of a holistic view to make sure that that's really what you want to do to create your life. So if you want any information, you can give us a call. We're happy to chat with you. My colleague John Bell and I deal with these things. So if you want to email us or just phone to have a chat, no charge, you can give us a phone or contact us by email. And if you want to have a look at the website, there's some stuff on the property projects over there.